Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from Tech Fans Ears. Before getting in depth into the installation and tweaks, let us understand the concept of AB partition in MIUI 2 device, or just in common. So yeah, we'll roll the intro. Unlike normal A-only or single partition devices, MIUI 2 has the AB partition which supports seamless updates. What does that mean? Just simple. We have two system partition, A and B. Whenever we receive the update, the system will download and apply the update in the offline partitions. For example, you are currently running and using your device through a system which is installed in partition A. While using that, if you are receiving the update, the system installs the update in the offline partition, which is system B. So whenever you reboot the device, it will boot the device through the partition B. How is it helpful? Well, there is no place where the user has to wait to use the device while it is just updating or applying the update. It will install, and whenever we reboot the device, it will boot from the updated system. It's like having the additional gas cylinder at home. Also, if any problem in the latest or updated firmware, we can just switch the partition to A and use the old one. What we need to understand: when it comes to installing the custom ROM in MIUI 2, we need to understand something, as our device has an AB partition. I would say like this: online and offline. Custom ROMs will be installed in offline partitions. TWRP zip will install in both the partition, both online and offline. GApps will be installed in online partition. So if you want to install the custom ROM, example, if you are in A partition and installing the custom ROM through TWRP, it will get installed in B partition. So after installing it, you need to switch the partition and reboot to your custom ROM. Also, one more thing to know is, recovery images are the part of boot image in our MIUI 2. So you need to install the TWRP zip after installing the custom ROM. Due to this reason, some of the ROMs nowadays comes with the pre-installed TWRP recoveries. Another thing is, if your ROM doesn't have GApps, you have to flash the GApps on the slot that your OS is actually on. If you just flash the ROM and TWRP, means you need to switch the partition and then you need to reboot to recovery. Then you need to flash GApps. Make sure to understand this concept before getting into installing the things. Due to this, we may get lot of trouble if we don't get the concept right. Don't worry, I will make these mistakes in upcoming videos, so you don't need to do it. That is what I wanted to explain in this video. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in next good one.